Dr. Sonal Dua has come. Yes, Dr. Sonal, please give us what you have from Ahmedabad. Her paper is going to be a comparison of newer and with conventional IOL power calculation formulas in adult eyes.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'll be presenting our study on where we have evaluated the accuracy of newer generation IOL formulas, Barrett Universal 2 and Hill RBF, with the conventional ones. So over the past decades, the term refractive cataract surgery is the term which is defined to, which has been used to define the cataract surgery because of the outcomes that we provide to the patients and with the appropriate accuracy. And also, the accurate IOL power formula is very important to achieve the post-targeted refraction. So one has to be very cautious in selecting the IOL power formula for the special axial lens. Calculation of intraocular lens power in eyes with shorter axial lens or longer still remains a challenge and often leads to unexpected postoperative myopia or hyperopia. When we looked into the literature, there is no single formula which works best for all the axial lens, and there has been a specific formula which has been given to a particular axial length of the eyes. So to evaluate the predictive accuracy of the newer formulas, Barrett Universal 2 and the Hill RBF, to the conventional ones, that is SRKT, Holaday 2, and Hoffer Q, in hypermetropes, emetropes, and myopes. It was a prospective observational study. 22 eyes were in the hypermetropic groups, 107 eyes in the emetropes, and 65 eyes in the myopic group. The standardized surgical technique was performed in all the cases where we did 2.2 mm temporal clear corneal incision was made, and accuracy of IOL SN60WF was implanted in all the cases. The IOL formula compared were SRKT, Barrett Universal 2, Hill RBF, Holaday 2, and Hoffer Q. Outcome measures, the best corrected visual acuity and the refraction was done at 3 months post-operatively. And the prediction error, that is predicted refraction minus the actual refraction was calculated, and the prediction error minus actual refraction without taking the signs into consideration, and that was the absolute prediction error, was calculated. Percentage of eyes within plus minus 0.5 diopters and 1 diopters of the predicted refraction was also analyzed. The results, mean age was 63.5, mean axial length for myopes was 27.58 mm, for emetropes, it was 23.45. In hypermetropes, it was 21.45. The prediction error for each formula was calculated. In hypermetropes, we observed that the SRKT and Holaday 2 showed us the least prediction error, and also the Barrett and Hill RBF gave us the least APE values, that is the absolute prediction error. And we observed that 87% of the eyes in both these groups, Barrett and Hill RBF, were within plus 0.5 to minus 0.5 diopters range. And 100% of the cases were between plus minus 1 diopters in SRKT group, Barrett, Hill RBF, and Holaday 2. For emetropic eyes, we saw that the Barrett performed very well with the least prediction error observed with the Barrett formula. And 90% of the eyes showed were between the prediction error of plus or minus 0.5 diopters. Followed by SRKT and Holaday 2, which also gave us very good results. In myopics, SRKT and Barrett performed very well and gave us the least prediction error, followed by Holaday 2. And also we could see that 100% of the eyes were between the prediction error of plus minus 0.5 diopters in the Barrett group and in the Holaday 2 group. So, and the results of our study was comparable to the recent studies which have been performed, and they have shown that the Barrett Universal formula has given them the better predictability and the least prediction error. So to conclude, all the five formulas performed very well in emetropes, hypermetropes, and myopes except the Hoffer Q. Emetropes, the least prediction error was observed with the Barrett 2 Universal, followed by Holaday 2 and SRKT, which was statistically significant. In hypermetropes, the least prediction was observed with Holaday 2 and SRKT, whereas the least APE value was seen with Barrett Universal 2 again and Hill RBF, which was statistically not significant. In myopes, the least prediction error was seen with the Barrett's Universal again and the SRKT, however, not statistically significant. And the highest percentage of eyes within 0.5 to plus, minus or plus 0.5 diopters were observed with the Barrett Universal 2 formula. So the Barrett Universal 2 formula has worked best for all the axial lens in our case series. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sonal. That's a wonderful paper. Once again, some questions.
What is it in the Barak formula that makes it the best of the lot?
So actually, there has been many things that they take into account, the axial length, the keratometer, but the Barrett has taken the lens thickness also in their formula. And there is a constant that is lens factor, which is different from the other formulas because it takes into account the principle, the difference in the principal axis. And that depends upon the IOL power and the shape and the design of the IOL, which always changes. If it's a plano convex and if it is flipped, then the principal axis changes and your ELP can change. So Barrett has taken all these things into account, the shape and the design and the power of the and the IOL power. And that helps in depicting the ELP, effective lens position of the lens. And from that they have derived a lens factor, which is different for every lens and different designs.
Dr. Sonal, I just want to tell you, you're also from Ahmedabad, and I have my respected guru, Dr. G.R. Patel. And I was in his operation theater, and he was saying, "Acha bhai, kya chahiye? Calculation kaise karna?" At that time, we didn't have all your lovely, lovely formulas, okay? So, dekho, aisa karte hain. K-meter lo. K-meter ka value ko divide karo. Minus karo refraction, aur wo IOL power dal do. Correct, sir?
Yes.
So, we took K-meter value. Suppose it's 44. We took 22. The patient was wearing -2, uska -2 karke 20 dal diya. That's a thumb rule.